Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television for Friday, May 17th, 2013. In the pre-market this morning, we do have stock index futures above fair value, so we are looking for a higher open at 9:30 Friday morning. Let's start off this morning looking overseas, and no alarm bells from Thursday's trading. We saw the FTSE in London make a higher high before pulling back. We saw a higher high for the DAX in Germany. Saw nice buying in Shanghai overnight. We saw continued buying in the Nikkei in Tokyo. The story with the yen hasn't ended yet, still in a downtrend here. If you move back, you can see when the story started back here in November, where we started to break down below the flypaper channel. We thought the story was about to end when we were starting to make a base here, but then finally broke down, and here we are making lower lows for the yen against the dollar. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices using the ETFs. After trading through the lower channel line, we came back up and into the channel. Crude oil is higher this morning, so not concerned about a sell signal on Friday. Gasoline continued to move higher on Thursday. Natural gas, after running up to the upper channel line, it has now reversed, and we're looking, we need a daily close on Friday above 21.99 to give us a buy signal for the UNG. Looking at copper, we came back up to the upper channel line on Thursday. A close above 41.03 would give us a buy signal on Friday. Gold is down in the pre-market this morning, so not concerned about a buy signal there. Platinum has traded down through the lower channel line for the last couple of days. A close below 145.22 would give us a sell signal on Friday. Looking at silver, it's down in the pre-market this morning. No change there. Moving over, looking at the major indexes, looking at the Dow Diamonds, we had an inside day yesterday, inside day for the Bank of America, had an inside day for the Spider for the S&P 500, fairly quiet for Sprint Nextel on Thursday. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, we actually had a bearish reversal day yesterday, so made a higher high, came back and closed lower on the day. The last time we had a bearish reversal signal in the NASDAQ was back here, and we traded through that right away. So we'll have to see if we can take out Thursday's high on Friday. But it was a very mixed picture, because we actually had a bullish reversal day for Apple Computer on Thursday. And then we had a stock like Cisco with a huge up day on Thursday, and a lot of sympathy plays for stocks in Cisco's sector, including EMC. But the bearish reversal day that we saw in the queues came from Google, and we had a bearish reversal day for Google on Thursday. Last time we had a bearish reversal day for Google was way back here, which did mark the top for that move after we played through a couple of bearish reversal signals just before that. So we'll have to see if we can take out Thursday's high in Google on Friday. Looking at the energy sector, we had an inside day on Thursday. Marathon Oil made a new high for this move and closed up 15 cents on the day. For financial services, we had some selling there but did not take out the previous day's low. Looking at Comerica, we made a new high for this move and then closed up 2 cents on the day. For home builders, saw a little more selling there, came down to the upper channel line. KB Homes came down to the lower channel line on Thursday. A close below 23.72 would give us a sell signal on Friday. 4 days of selling in metals and mining has finally generated a new sell signal. At the same time, Freeport was up on Thursday. A close below 31.23 would give us a sell signal on Friday. So we've been down to the lower channel line a couple of days, but have not been able to close below it. For transports, fairly quiet day yesterday. We saw some selling, but did not take out the previous day's low. And looking at United, it actually had an inside day on Thursday, so a day of indecision, and we'll look for some market direction on Friday. But so far it looks like we're going back up to retest Thursday's highs at the open on Friday. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. You can see that we're starting to project lower prices here. Had a couple of early warning signals and saw a little bit of a pullback. Not too concerned so far, and certainly we would not get overly concerned unless we started breaking down below the flypaper channel. So right now, the bottom of the flypaper channel is down at 1620 and moving higher. The other day, we were talking about the fact we were up at the top of our projected range, and so 1656.25, we were looking for resistance there. And then, of course, I said if we continue to move higher here, range would start to recalculate. And if we move to the daily chart, we could get our next price target, which was 1687.50. Now, a couple of days later, we've started to project higher prices up here. And so if we start to break through above the recent range up at just above 1656.25, then 1671.88 would be our next intraday target. And then, of course, above that is 1687.50. Right now, we're on an intraday sell signal as of the last 2 hours of trading on Thursday. And if we move back up, and it looks like we're going to head back up there at the open, an hourly close above 1657.90 would give us an intraday buy signal on Friday. Okay, folks, that's all for Friday morning. Looking over my shoulder, futures are pretty well where I left them earlier, and so they're above fair value. So we looks like we're going to see some buying at the open on Friday morning. Have a great day, have a great weekend, and I'll talk to you again next on Monday morning.